Before we begin, let's have a look at the possible scenarios for a IP side connect system. The first scenario that we'll look at is a pretty simple one, and this is essentially two repeaters connected directly to each other, either via Ethernet cable or via Ethernet switch or via fiber optic. So there is a effectively a direct connection between the master repeater here on the left and the peer repeater on the right. Now, if there were more peer repeaters, the configuration on the other peer repeaters would be essentially the same. The only thing is you would change certain parameters like IP addresses and radio IDs. So looking at the parameters that we'll put into the repeaters, it always makes a good idea to write these things down before you begin. So looking at the master repeater, the radio ID is 1. It has an IP address 192.168.1.1 and uses UDP port 50,000. I've set up slot 1 to be wired and slot 2 to be local. So when you talk on slot 1, you'll go out on both repeaters. If you talk on slot 2, you'll only go out on the repeater on which your radio is roamed to or you have selected. Then looking at the peer repeater, this has radio ID 2. IP address is 192.168.1.2. You'll see that the IP address in this case is static. I've assumed that there is no DHCP server sitting somewhere in this network, so we make it static IP all around. The UDP port in this case is 50,001. So what I like to do is to give the repeaters each their own unique UDP port. This makes particularly sense if you are going to have multiple repeaters behind a router, then the router is able to easily handle the port forwarding. The other possible configuration is a also pretty much the same, except the two repeaters are now connected to each other via some form of other network to which they are connected via a router. So you have the master repeater on the left, and this is connected to a router, and the router is in turn connected to the customer enterprise network, a fancy name for a company WAN. Or this cloud here could effectively be the internet. So you could have the router connected to the internet and it goes through the internet service provider, through the internet cloud, and eventually pops out here at the peer end. And the peer also is connected to the cloud via a router and internet connection. Looking at the parameters for this, a little bit more complex, the master repeater and the peer repeater are pretty much the same. The only difference here is, of course, the two routers. So the router, and I'm not going to go into the configuration of the router as such, but what you have to have is you have to have that the router forward traffic on UDP port 50,000, it forwards it to the IP address of the master repeater. So the router here has to have a static IP address on the WAN side, and the master also needs to have a static IP address. So what the router is able to do is it's able to forward traffic on port 50,000, UDP port 50,000, able to forward it to the master, and we know that the master is always at this IP address of 192.168.1.2. It's 1.2 because on the LAN side, the router is now occupying the IP address 192.168.1.1. So the master has to take the next available address, which is 1.2. On the peer side, pretty much the same. The only difference here is that the route is now forwarding port 50,001. The pier, in this case, since the router has this little DHCP server inside it, we then can use a DHCP all around. The peer repeater also uses UDP port 50,000, as we saw in the previous example.